To all examples, we cannot apply syntheric divisions. If the equation, if this algebraic equation has total, all the total roots are imaginary, then syntheric division not works for that examples. In that case, we apply another example, that is factorize this polynomial in two brackets, in two factors. So there are different methods to solve, to find the roots of algebraic equations, and we have already studied these methods from 5th standard to 12th standards. So if we have problem in factorizing this polynomial, then refer the 5th standard, 6th standard, 7th standards, 8th, 9th, 10th standards books of mathematics. So what are the values of m? 2, 2, 2, and +1. We have, if we factorize the polynomial, then we have easily roots. Or so this 2, 2, 2 repeated 3 times, and then for the general solution of the given differential equation is what? Is y is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x e raised to 2x. So this is the part in the solution corresponding to these three roots, 2, 2 and 2. So these are repeated roots. Don't write that c1 e raised to 2x plus c2 e raised to 2x plus c3 e raised to 2x. Don't write this. We write c1 plus c2x plus c3x e raised to 2x plus the term corresponding to this one is what? Is next constant. Next is c4 e raised to 1 into x, that is e raised to x. So this is the general solution. If we consider this 1 at first place and then 2, 2, 2, then we have another solution, another form of the solution. So this is about the repeated real roots. Then next type is, type number 3 is non-repeated imaginary roots, complex roots. So suppose the m1 is alpha 1 plus beta 1 I and m2 is alpha 2 minus alpha 1 minus m1, m2 is what? Alpha 1 minus beta 1 I. We know that the complex roots are occurs in conjugate pairs. Suppose out of the n roots of auxiliary equation, that is m1, m2, mn, two roots are imaginary. Obviously, imaginary roots occurs in conjugate pairs means they are in even number. That is, out of n roots of auxiliary equations, 2 are imaginary, or 4 are imaginary, or 6 are imaginary. Okay, so suppose the first two, m1 and m2, are imaginary. That is, m1 is alpha 1 plus beta 1 I and its conjugate alpha 1 minus beta 1 I. m2 is this. So what is the corresponding part? The corresponding part of solution of the given differential equation f(dy) is equal to 0 is what? That is, the part corresponds to roots m1 and m2 in solution. For example, corresponding to 1, the part is what? c4 e raised to x. Like that, the corresponding parts is what? c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x. The part in the solution corresponding to m1 and m2, c1 e raised to mnx plus c2 e raised to mx. That is equal to c1 e raised to alpha 1 plus beta 1 I x plus c2 e raised to m2, value of m2, alpha 2 minus, not alpha 2, alpha 1 minus beta 1 I x. That is equal to c1 e raised to alpha 1 x into e raised to beta 1 x I plus c2 e raised to alpha 1 x e raised to minus beta 1 x I. Best same. So addition of powers. If we multiply these two, what we have? We have this term, e raised to alpha 1 x plus beta 1 x I. Then is equal to c1 e raised to this part e raised to alpha 1 x and e raised to alpha 1 x is common in these two terms. So write e raised to alpha 1 x in bracket c1 e raised to beta 1 x I plus c2 e raised to minus beta 1 x I is equal to next step e raised to alpha 1 x in bracket c1. Then use this concept as e raised to I theta is what? E raised to I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta, and e raised to minus I theta is cos theta minus I sin theta. So we have is equal to e raised to beta 1 x I is what in bracket cos beta 1 x plus I sin beta 1 x, value of this e raised to beta 1 x, e raised to theta I theta plus c2 in round bracket cos beta 1 x minus sin beta 1 x, right here, minus sin beta 1 x, round bracket complete, square bracket complete. Value of this e raised to minus I theta is cos theta by using this rule as this. Then next step, is equal to e raised to alpha 1 x in bracket c1 cos beta 1 x plus I c1 sin beta 1 x plus c2 cos beta 1 x minus c2 sin beta 1 x e raised to alpha 1 x in bracket. So from these two term we have c1 plus c2 cos beta 1 x plus I plus these two terms right here I into sin beta 1 x. So c1 in another bracket I c1 minus I c2 sin beta 1 x, this term, from these two terms take this sin beta 1 x as common. So what do we have? I c1 and at this place I c2 in one bracket. And then next step is e raised to alpha 1 x, write this c1 plus c2 as capital A cos beta 1 x plus this is capital B, suppose this is another constant, I c1 IC1 minus IC2, value of this IC1 minus IC2 as capital B sine beta 1x. So this is the corresponding part. This is the corresponding. So write note, if m1 is equal to alpha 1 plus beta 1x, right? If m1 alpha 1 plus beta 1x and minus alpha 1 minus beta 1x are imaginary roots, of auxiliary equation, then the corresponding part or terms, parts or terms in general solution are what? E raised to alpha 1x in bracket c1 cos beta 1x plus c2 sin beta 1x. This is the terms, these are the terms corresponds to the non-repeated imaginary roots alpha 1 plus minus beta 1x. So write note number 6, second, then type 4, last type that repeated imaginary roots. Suppose m1 is equal to alpha 1 plus beta 1 I, m2 is equal to alpha 1 minus beta 1 I repeated twice. Then the corresponding terms in general solutions are e raised to alpha 1x in bracket c1 plus c2 x cos beta 1x plus c3 plus c4 x sin beta 1x. If these roots, complex roots, repeated twice, then what is the corresponding terms in the general solutions? E raised to alpha 1x, this alpha 1x, plus c1 plus c2 x cos beta 1x plus c3 plus c4 x sin beta 1x. Suppose this m1, these roots alpha 1 plus minus beta 1 I repeated 3 times. Suppose these roots repeated 3 times. Then what is the corresponding part? Then the corresponding parts or corresponding terms in general solution are e raised to alpha 1 x in bracket c1 plus c2 x plus c3 x square cos beta 1 x plus c4 plus c5 x plus c6 x square sin beta 1 x. So we have total 6 constants in this solution.